Hi, this is Chuck Burch coming to you from New Tech again. We're gonna go ahead and set the runout tables up today. First thing I wanna show you is the way these things hook up. You can see there's five holes here and you can set five legs stands on this for transport. A lot of times they are a little loose with the pins. Some of the people out in the field will put bungee cords around them to keep them tight and keep them from rattling. So we're gonna go ahead and disconnect it. You can set those right there. And right there. Also, if you want, you can also pin them in here and lock it down. That way it's a good place to store them rather than on the table. So we're gonna go ahead and take it down. We're gonna walk it around and set it up. The legs are gonna go away from the machine, from the table. Flip it over, get the leg down. And we're gonna go ahead and set this on. Okay, after we get this part set, you wanna go ahead and back this all the way out. Back this side all the way out. We're gonna lift them up to where we're fairly level. And we're gonna tighten them up. Then what we're gonna do is we're gonna run a panel out just a little ways, because you want this level. You don't want it up too high and you don't want it down too low, because then your panel will come out and on a long run it will come out and bow the panel to where you won't be able to hang it properly on the roof. And what you want is the panel to come out, and it looks like we need it just, oh, that's actually really good there. We actually got it set. So with the adjustments, I think I'm gonna go down a little bit with it. So we're gonna loosen this leg. Loosen like this leg here. We're gonna wiggle it down to where it looks pretty decent. We're sitting on the table just about right. Set it up to where we look pretty level. And that's how you set up a runout table on our machine. And then you can go ahead, if you have more tables, you're running longer lengths, you can go ahead and set the next one up and do 2, 3, 4, 5 of them.